Hello my dear students, today I will teach you the new chapter Income from Other Sources. See guys, already we know as per the Income Tax Act, the income of an individual is classified into five heads. First one is income from salary, second one income from house property, third one income from business and profession, fourth one capital gains, and the fifth one income from other sources. The calculation of income from first four heads already we have discussed in the previous classes. So today I will take up the last head, that is income from other source. So here what exactly we learn is the calculation of taxable income from other sources. So before going for the calculation, first we should know the meaning of this income, that's income from other source. So let's know the meaning first. The income which does not fall under any other head, that is income from salary, house property, business and profession, and capital gain, is called income from other sources. Let me explain this with one example. Just imagine I am the individual and earning income from different sources. So maybe from my salary, my own house property, business, my profession, and investment, that is capital gain. So apart from this, if any other income, if I am earning, means that falls under the fifth head, income from other sources. Hope you have got my point. Understood. So next let us move on to the calculation of taxable income from other sources. To calculate, there is a format. This is the format which includes two things. One is income from other sources under section 56 and deductions under section 57. So here if you deduct the deductions under section 57 from the income from other sources, you will get the taxable income from other sources. So to calculate this, first we should know in detail about these incomes and deductions. Which are the incomes and deductions comes under this? So in detail about this incomes and expenses, I will teach you in the next video. Thank you so much. Hello students, welcome to the second video about income from other sources. So in the last video till here, I explained how to calculate the taxable income of other sources, where we can see two things, incomes and deductions. So let us know in detail about incomes. So which are the incomes we have to take here? It is a very big list. These are the incomes we are taking under the calculation of taxable income of other sources. The first one is interest on bank deposit. What it is? So here SSE will deposit in the bank in the form of FD, RD and all, and from that he will receive the interest. It is an income to him and which is not related to first four head, salary, house property, business and profession, and capital gain. So it comes in other sources. Next one is interest on loan. This one, sometimes the SSE will give the loan to the third party on interest and receive the interest. It is an income to him which is not related to first four heads. So we take here. Next, interest on investment, interest on securities. See, there are two kinds of investment. We invest in movable property and immovable property. when we invest in immovable property, we will not get any interest or any income. When we are investing in securities, regularly we receive the interest from that. So it is an income to the assessee, not related to first to four heads. So take under other sources. Next is dividend. So there are three kinds of dividend. One is proposed dividend, interim dividend, and DIP dividend. So these are the dividends received by an assessee. Actually speaking, it is exempted. About the dividend, I'll speak in detail later. I think you people have heard about DDT and CDT, corporate dividend tax and dividend distribution tax. It means that the corporate will pay the tax on the dividend. That's why it is exempted from in the hands of a recipient. It is not taxable. So in detail, I will speak later about dividend. Next one is MP and MLA salary. Even though it is a salary of MP and MLA, it does not fall under the head salary because it does not meet the definition of salary. What is the definition of salary? Employee should receive the consideration from the employer for rendering certain service, maybe 8 to 12 hours. That is called salary. Here, MP and MLA are not rendering any service, just they are doing the administration work of the government. Government is not an employer and MP and MLA is not an employee. So that's so it is not meeting the definition of salary. It does not come under the head salary. It takes under other sources. So I will continue in next video.